Hello, fellow internet user. If you're watching this, then I'm sorry to say that you committed the logical fallacy known as ad hominem. So what exactly does this Latin word salad even mean? It literally means to the man. In layman's terms, you've committed a logical fallacy whereby you have definitively lost the argument.
But why have I lost the argument?
I hear you scream. Well, you've failed to engage with the content of your opponent's argument and have instead engaged in a personal attack, which means you don't get to pass go, you don't collect $200, or even $400 if you're playing the current year gender discrimination version. Okay, you may still be confused. I'll break this down Barney style. Let's say that the Dread Pirate Roberts is having a discussion with a man named, Mr. Chav. Roberts has just stated that Benny Hinn is a heretic and a false prophet, all while standing in front of a
literal mountain of evidence.
Mr. Chav, intimidated by the
literal mountain of evidence,
decides to completely ignore it and says,
"Well, you're a Pharisee."
That is an ad hominem attack, albeit not a very good one. On a sliding scale of insults from, say, Ario Speedwagon to Van Halen, they're somewhere between Milli Vanilli and, Striper. Calling someone a Pharisee objectively makes no sense. Pharisees were heretics who did not care about sound doctrine and just made up rules and stuff. Not unlike Cat Kerr thinking she can Gandalf a hurricane with a stick. Regardless, even if the Dread Pirate Roberts happened to be a Pharisee, it still wouldn't negate his argument or the
literal mountain of evidence
he's compiled. Sorry, Mr. Chav, but even the Huffington Post thinks your ad hominem is fake news. If you found this video helpful, please leave a like, a comment, and feel free to share it with any and all internet acquaintances who are guilty of behaving in a logically fallacious manner. Thank you.